Kitchen Wizard. Welcome to hour six of the ALF-A-THON. If you're here to listen to tracks from former Yazoo singer Alison Moyet's 1984 debut solo album, ALF, well, you're going to be disappointed because we're partway through all 26 episodes of season two of Puppeteer, Paul Fusco's masterpiece, ALF.
Okay, good one. Again, don't confuse those acronyms. ALF is Alien Life Form. Now, this is an episode called Hail to the Chief. And let's dive in. And hope the tracking's good.
Do you play hi-hat?
I want to learn.
I want to learn just that part. I would like to point out that right now Steve is kind of bopping along to the ALF theme. That funky bass has got Steve in a...
He's doing
a tizzy.
More than that chair dancing that I wanted to do from last night's VCR party.
Isn't chair dancing like a...
We do have that video right behind these ALF cuts, actually. Hi, ALF. Yeah, that's what Brian says. And then, ALF, I'm on the phone. That's what Lenny says.
Yeah, I'm always... I'm interested in how they got the lens to fog up.
Yeah, and the mirror shot too, or else in the mirror you gotta frame the actual camera out of
that. Until we see blue dots in front of our eyes.
Did we get a tip?
No, we're watching the presidential debate on TV.
Sorry, I've been
not me.
The president's talking on TV. Do you think they'll have Harry Shearer as a Reagan impersonator?
It's important to know.
Didn't
what the
he appear
are.
As in season
yeah,
one?
Yeah, we didn't
why
see
do I know
him
that?
But we heard his voice.
Why? You don't.
She's not my mother.
Mom, I'm supposed to go down to the mall with Julie.
Lizard got a job at the new Wiener on a Stick place. You're gonna make fun of his hair net.
The other sitcom trope is
Wiener on a Stick.
Well, just any restaurant, like it'd be called like Chicken Pete's, and they have to wear a giant chicken on their head. It's always some funny. I'd never been to a fast food restaurant where they had to wear a wacky.
You should stay home and watch
not yet.
The debate.
Since when have
so
you
long,
been
Steve.
Interested
bye,
in
bye, Steve.
You
may your wind
kidding?
Be bitten.
Back on Melmac, I was a
registered. Oh, we got a tip.
Demo
Marty gets his treat.
Yeah, we were a political party. And a doo-wop group. Can I vote for the acerbic guy in the middle?
Well, in answer to your question, as Joe Biden once said,
whoa.
We have nothing to fear but fear itself. And by arming ourselves against the impossible, we are preventing the unthinkable from becoming the inevitable.
Double talk. Preventing war.
Did they really just say Joe Biden?
They sure did.
People who are mad at each other.
Somebody remind me to excerpt that.
You expect Reagan and Gorbachev to kiss?
Somebody other than me.
Not on the lips.
Yeah, not you. You don't. You won't remember this day ever happened.
It's very complex.
Oh, whoa!
Power bar two.
Biting political satire in this episode.
Well, Willie's ass. What was that? That was the most Willie's ass I've ever seen.
We saw his nipple in season one. Now we see Willie's ass. That would have been definitely the title of this episode, and will be as I break these up. Willie's ass. Ooh, dream sequence. Writers got bored.
Just Anna, our environment is becoming endangered, much like the liberal. What would you do about it?
Saving the liberal?
I'm referring to pollution.
Well, my environmental plan includes tax incentives to the industrial sector to encourage factory modernization, as well as legislation...
Oh, lunch meat! Kennedy...
Did I post a lot of clips of this
your
around
solution
the last
to
election?
Pollution?
Yes, I did.
My solution to pollution will help your constitution. So send the contribution and start the revolution.
Did they reference having an orange president? Yes.
Could we please get serious here?
Quiet. Rapmaster ALF is on a roll.
Was it just an excuse to show an ALF clip? Yes.
Wiener on a stick.
Rapmaster ALF is on a roll. Now that has to be in a mix.
Ralph
Levins, where are you?
Just tie big balloons on all the smokestacks to catch the dirty air.
Those terrible ideas, but the crowd loves
and
them.
What would you do when the balloons were full?
Well, like, how are you going to be a good president?
We've covered this. I sleep Joe Pickett style.
Do you really?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Well, no wonder you don't want to come on the road with us. I'm not going to vote for him.
I don't want you to have to deal with a nude Joe and a nude...
No, I'd be in a room with two nude VCR party co-hosts.
And then your fortune cookie, you will spend every night next week with two naked men in a hotel room, would be true.
It does start that way.
Yeah, and end that way.
We're getting ripped from the headlines 1987 stuff right here.
Don't worry, it's the black phone. President here.
Really? Yeah, no problem. Yeah, thank you.
There's no problem with drinking one?
Excuse me, Kate. I'm off to South Dakota.
I think it was.
I've got a rendezvous with history.
Look at it. Early Photoshop here. Well, if only in real life.
It's not too late.
What do you think, Kate? Huh?
Left with a chisel and enough time in South Dakota.
I think you look silly next to Abe Lincoln.
And I think Valerie should have stayed with her family. But hey, it's her career.
Oh! Let's hear what the Valerie promo is after this one.
What do you want now?
I finally figured out why your political system is so complicated. That's just the way your world works.
If things were simpler on Melmac, huh?
Yeah. If we didn't understand something, we broke it.
It's too bad life here isn't that way. It would be nice to have people dancing in the streets.
Huh?
Alf, I dreamt you were president. And you were right about everything. Every problem had a simple answer.
Sounds nice.
Why?
Good night, Kate.
There's that picture.
Yeah.
Really?
Before you get up for that final snack,
this probably aired November around election time.
I'll be right back.
Because we watched the Halloween.
It's a timely tie-in in that time.
It was a timely tie-in.
Wow.
Mom, did you see my other...
Shh.
Sorry.
They had a puppeteer operating the feet.
Well, Lynn. You get me out of here.
Contract mandated line from Lynn.
Next, yep. It's the emotionally charged true story of a loving couple who stop at almost nothing to have the children they want so much. Mayor Winningham and Keith Carradine are the blind couple who challenge the law in the world premiere movie, Eye on the Sparrow.
President Reagan
and General Secretary Gorbachev's historic meeting. How will it affect the future of our two nations? An NBC News special on the summit tonight on NBC.
But no Valerie.